go about our daily lives unaware of just how illusory and tenuous our sense of security is, almost always blind to most goings-on. But this week, real trauma struck the Bakers and made them take notice. In fact, they not only took notice, they sat up and begged.
Last time I'm going to tell you this. Now you put those tops on, or I'm going to arrest you both.
Man,
why are you going to mess with us?
That was their second warning. The first one fell on deaf ears and breasts.
You remember what I told you now?
Screw them. I'm working on my tan.
Hi, I'm Tiffany.
I'm Brenna.
Let's go get a tan.
Do it.
That's right. Verna,
you're the best mistress I've ever had.
That's right.
Hello.
Yo.
Listen, man, we're down at the beach and we got big trouble.
I bet you do. Now, you people aren't very good swimmers.
What? Billy, just listen to me, man! Yo, just, I'm gonna drown your little redneck behind when I see you. Just find the bacon. Crazy, man. Why don't you arrest somebody that's doing something, man?
Go ahead. What are you doing here?
Get out of the way, will ya?
I want your badge number, A. Rose Love.
Being arrested for public indecency, you want to step back?
Indecency?
Oh, for God's sake, Tiffany, what the hell's going on here? Oh, my God.
Hi, Sanford.
Hi there.
You know this woman?
Yes. This is one of my patients. This is Miss Maxwell, is
Miss or Mrs., whatever.
Nice to see you again. This is my Beverly. This is Beverly.
Nice to meet you. Oh, sorry.
Listen, officer, this is my daughter, and this is my patient, and I'm a doctor. If you could just release them into my custody, I promise nothing like this will ever happen again. I promise.
Daddy, you cannot tell me what to do. Tiffany, shut up.
Irritable? Mrs. Baker? She was just warming up.
Is it asking too much to have non-fat milk in the house?
I live here too, damn it. Screw recycling. The rest of the world wants to be like selfish pigs, well then so can I. Men, there's no damn non-fat milk! Can a woman even have coffee the way she wants it in her own house? I'll drink it black. I don't like it black, but I'll drink it black. My head hurts. Who the hell took my ibuprofen?
All right, take the cuffs off.
Thank you.
But I don't want to see either of them out here again like this. You understand?
Not a problem.
Yo, they call me anyway. What the hell are you going to do about it?
Tight.
Thanks, Sanford.
Oh, nothing. Nothing
Thanks,
at all.
Daddy. Listen, miss, it's perfectly all right with me if you want to use my husband's services, but please, I think it's a good idea to stay away from my daughter. She's just a kid.
This is a family issue, Miss Maxwell, please.
Oh, well, right. Yeah. Wow. Very nice to meet you all.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Bernie. Give me a call.
I will.
She will?
Dr. B, if she's one of your patients, man, you the man. I love nudity, man. I can look at a naked woman all day and all night. You know what I'm saying? Yo, kid, nudity is the bomb, man. It's slamming. All of it. The art books, the porno mags, the dressing rooms and the clothing stores with the little curtains. Man, I love you for nudity. Yo, they should legalize it, man. You know, anytime, any place, under any circumstances, period. End of discussion. Now, I don't see what the problem is.
Well, what if I showed you some naked pictures of your mother?
What? The hell's wrong with you, man? I'll bust your ass, man. I don't care if you're the prick.
Tiffany, why on earth didn't you put your top back on when the officer told you to?
She busted out like Rodney King and showed the man.
She showed everybody.
Daddy, you don't have to get
out of me, you know. It's not like I got arrested or anything.
Yeah, no thanks to the rest of you.
Look, nobody got hurt. What's the big deal? Let's just get out of here.
Tiffany, your actions will be punished.
Yeah, right. God's going to send us all to hell for taking off our top.
I'm so sure. Look, let's just leave God out of this. No God, no deities, no Allah, no nothing.
What happened to Mrs. Baker believing in every God in the phone book? Watch.
Oh, look at that. Oh, look at this angel song.
How dare he betray my feelings of trust like that? I hope they put him under the jail.
What happened?
Oh, they caught your aunt's new guru. He ripped off her credit cards and maxed them out buying jet skis and hair transplants.
Another quack guru? Min is so surprised.
You know what? I have just had it with this spirituality and growth stuff. I am done being dumped on by New Age gurus.
Are you serious?
You bet I am. I've had it up to here with all these creeps who care more about dialing 555 tits on my MasterCard than they do about my feelings.
Just remember one thing. This country was founded by Puritans. There were no thong bikinis at Plymouth Rock.
No cops either. No brothers.
No aloe.
Yeah, man, Plymouth Rock sucks. What? Are you out of your mind? Plymouth Rock is a symbol of freedom.
So are tan buns.
Well, better dead than new.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yo, bust them up, hey. P. Bust them up, man. Take them down, P. Take them down, man. Take them down, P. It's not just a moral thing. It's about common decency, too. There are a lot of people, all women, that I would love to see naked. Then there are others, like Maureen Reagan, that I just assume leave mentally bundled up. So I think until we can decide collectively as a nation who we'd like to see in the all together, we should probably all just keep our clothes on.
What the hell is this?
Oh,
for crying out loud, I just had this detailed.
Dr. Pig?
Oh, yeah. Hair's coming down, Pops. This is word, Mom, from the brothers, because you ain't erasing no crows feet in the ghetto.
Oh, man, kill that noise. You know black don't crack. So our skin don't crinkle like white people.
Oh, that's right. Our skin is smooth.
God, Sanford. The whole world is turning to crap. We need to redecorate something.
Boof. Punk-ass fools out of bust on side their head.
What? Oh, how many times are we going to have it in one life? 4-8.
I said we protest their asses.
Oh, hopefully. Hey, listen, nobody's protesting anything.
Listen, Tiff, what you got to see is that the white male power establishment treating the women almost as bad as they treating our people. You understand
right.
that?
Word.
So we got to protest.
I think Tyler's pretty bad with this race thing. But I don't know, he could have a point. I mean, look at Joan of Arc. They set her on fire. And Susan B. Anthony, who fought for a woman's right to vote, they made her into a fat, ugly coin that nobody wants to use. I think something's going on.
Hey, what are you doing to Dr. Baker's car? Leave that alone. No, wait. I can't call the police.
No,
you see, I'm a documentary filmmaker. I'm making a documentary about Dr. Baker and his family. I can't get involved in any way.
So you don't care if the scumbag gets totaled?
Well, cinematically speaking, no. So what's this all about?
It's about men who demand women look like Barbie dolls, or they won't play with us. Do you want to come out and make out in my dream convertible with me? Oh, no! Not until you've inflated your chest cavity with leaky plastic bags! Oh, and stop eating, girl. And if you die from too much dieting and exercise, well, who cares? Now, what's your next question, dickhead?
A woman called in. She really, really hates you.
Dr. Pig, you will charbroil in hell?
What? I only write down what she says.
No, you'll charbroil in hell, lightly basted with the fat from the women whose thighs you have suctioned.
All right, that does it, Sanford. I'm calling the realtor. What? We are selling the house.
Another satisfied customer, huh?
Get out of the way.
Dr. Pig. Just because somebody knows this stupid dog too well, I must scrub his car. You know, if this car were bigger, I would write Mrs. Pig.
Ah, Jesus, man, what are you trying to do here, poison us?
What?
Well, there's food still on this. Here, move.
don't you watch what I'm doing and maybe you'll learn something, for God's sake? I can't find any good help. All the incompetence.
Aunt Beth, are you okay?
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, I've just never seen you wash a dish before, or mop a floor, or any of the other menial tasks that women excel at.
Pig nephew.
Gee, this is great. I mean, if we can get you back in the kitchen, maybe there's still hope for Hillary.
You know, I could use some pointers in cleaning toilets, too.
Could I just get some room here to breathe? Thank you.
Come on.
The house is just so filled with clutter, nobody knows how to clean anything around here. Up to me all the time. Up to me.
Beverly Baker, a traditional homemaker? There's a side of her I'd never thought I'd see. And here's a side of Min I'd pay to see.
Yes, Tonto. Mm-hmm. You can put on the mask. You know it, big red guy. I'm your Kimosabi. Mm-hmm. Scout's much prettier than silver. Now bring them both into the teepee so they can watch. Boys wearing horseshoes are such a turn-on. Mm-hmm. Now you take off that headdress and put on that red dress and hi-ho, Silver, away!
Dr. Baker!
Don't do that.
Sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
No, it's this stalker thing. I'm just a little bit edgy, you know. You haven't seen anything, like, suspicious around here, have you?
No. No. Not that I can think of.
What do you want?
Oh, I wanted to ask you a question. If nude beaches were legal, how would you feel about Tiffany going topless?
Well, if they were legal... No, I don't like the idea of creepy guys looking at her. She's still my little girl.
Well, do you think you'd mind if you were, say, French?
Well, probably not. Because if I was French, by definition, I'd be a jerk.
Tyler, you seem really incensed about this public nudity issue. Do you see it as racial?
Of course he does. He sees bubble baths as being racial. Look, the white man built civilization because he's sexually repressed. See, the black man don't need no civilization because he got it in his heart and in his spirit.
Pig Junior.
The white man, see, he needs clothes to keep the social order. See?
Off you go, girl.
But the black man, he don't need clothes. He just keep the order with some cool-ass footwear, you know what I'm saying?
My world.
All this. Take a five, honey. This isn't happening. I'm sorry.
Yesterday really made me hot.
Hot? It was a catastrophe. 800 miles of California beaches, and you go skinny dipping on the same one as my daughter.
I know. Me, you, your daughter, and your wife. Oh, danger really turns me on.
You are out of your mind, aren't you?
Oh. A man, his wife, and his mistress. Oh, it's just like a foreign film. I get to play the innocent young Belgian milkmaid who's taken advantage of by the evil German commander, Karl Klaus von Schmelz.
Look, everything's okay between us, right?
Jawohl.
And listen, you're the best mistress I've ever had.
That's right. You know, Sanford, your wife seemed really angry. An angry suburban housewife. Oh, Sanford, no one to return to me.
If you were having a problem with me, you'd talk to me, right? You wouldn't just, like, slash my tires, would you?
I'm prettier than she is, aren't I? Tell me I'm prettier
than
she is.
Honey, want to focus here, please?
Say I'm prettier.
I mean, you didn't write pig on my car.
I know I'm prettier, but I could be even prettier. Oh, Sanford, you can do it. You're an artist with a scalpel. You can make me prettier than the rain and the flowers. Oh, Sanford, you could turn me into a moonscape.
Uh-oh.
Really, you can.
Honey, you're rambling again.
Oh, that's it. Sanford, you can do it. I know you can.
Whoa.
Ow.
Oh, you're hurting me.
Oh,
hey, guys. Come on, let's go. I got everything we need to make our protest sign. Tina's inside waiting.
Yo, chill, sister woman. We're taking down some rays. You don't need us.
For real.
Tyler, this is your idea, so get off your butt. And if my body's going to front this protest, you better do some heavy lifting, too.
God damn!
Oh, damn my ass, man. You wanted to protest, Reverend Sharpton. Come on.
My mother would die if she found out I went to a nude beach. See, in Korea, only bar girls and cheap, ugly whores would be seen naked in public. But that's why I like your country, because I like checking out a buffed out stud just as much as the next girl. That's why I go to the movies. But you know, American movies are sexist. They make the girls show everything, and the men don't have to show anything. I don't know, maybe they're afraid to. Perhaps if Stallone were to show full frontal nudity, maybe he's not the biggest star in Hollywood.
Well, it all started back in the 30s when Hoover's people spread that rumor about Eleanor Roosevelt being ugly. Well, says who? And now it has led to this carnage of plastic surgery that endangers women. It is time that women stop letting men set the standards for female beauty.
So you're saying that plastic surgery is a male plot against women?
You bet I am. It's a damn plot and you don't see it because you're too busy committing testosterone-induced atrocities. Open your eyes. Do you see anybody pressuring guys to go under the knife for a Ken doll's flat genitals?
Check, please.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm pulling all the stinking weeds. I'm killing all the stupid flowers. It's dying no matter what you do with them anyway.
Aunt Bev, I know you're upset and angry about tossing away your false gods. I think maybe it's time you considered Catholicism.
What?
You see, Aunt Bev, you sort of flipped your spiritual etch-a-sketch and have given it a good shake. So religiously, you've got a clean slate.
Exactly.
So with Catholicism, you can indulge in an elaborate belief system that completely controls every aspect of your life.
Billy, you're not even Catholic.
I know, but it's...
Forget it. Not interested.
You'd really like Catholicism. They're big into mystic statues, robes, that smelly stuff. It's the best of Christianity combined with the glitz of paganism. It's a good match.
Forget it. I'm not listening.
But, and Ben...
I'm not listening!
Have,
Daddy, you gotta call the police!
What happened?
Who?
She killed the cat!
Honey, we don't have a cat.
We do now.
Jeez.
I'll get the walk.
Poor Uncle Sanford. Just can't help but feel that his harassment is part and parcel of the moral decay in this country today. Depravity seeping out from the ghettos.
Hey. Hold on a second, my mentally deprived cousin. You ain't trying to say that my pop Stalker's a brother, is you?
Yeah, what's up with that? Well, I'm only speaking statistically, but 4 out of 10 African-American men in California, I eat blacks.
Uh-huh.
Are either in prison, on probation, or on their way to 7-Eleven with a Mac 9.
Well, statistically speaking, you come from the group of most scary brothers. White guy.
That's right, man. All these serial killers were Caucasoid. Ted Bundy, white man. John Wayne Gacy, white man.
Jeffrey Dahmer, white man. See.
The freeway killer, white man. Now name one serial killer that was a brother.
Ted Kennedy.
What? Yo, man, that was one person. It was an accident, and he ain't black.
Yeah, well, he votes like one. Besides, who's that guy down in Atlanta, the goofy guy?
Yeah, goofy. See, you can't name one.
Exactly. Hey, what about all them serious hard-time killers? White devils, Hitler. Stalin.
Yeah, what about Genghis Khan and his horde?
Genghis wasn't white. He was part of men's crowd.
Hey! Stick him!
You know, you should really thank me in advance for this next scene. Told ya.
Mom! What do you mean sneaking up on me like that when you know that there's a stalker loose?
Well, you don't have anything to worry about, Mom. I think she only wants to hurt Dad.
Okay, I'm busy.
Well, I need your advice on something. See, Tina borrowed my white gloves and spilled coffee on him, and now she wants to borrow my cashmere vest, and I'm just not comfortable loaning it to her. What should I do?
Tiffany, how should I know what the hell you should do? Can't you see I'm cleaning my closet? Just once, I'd like to see you come up here and say, Mom, is there anything I can do for you today? Is there anything I can do to make your day a little better? You never do it. Never.
Sanford, I almost bit her head off. I am so miserable. I just don't believe in anything anymore.
I'm just looking. No harm in looking. Maybe a little incense. Incense doesn't have to be religious. It makes the house smell nice.
My money, too, you know. No, I won't do it. Willpower. One day at a time.
It's like I don't serve any purpose at all. I might as well just live in the subway or be a prostitute. It doesn't matter.
Oh, of course it does. Hey, listen to me, will you? You don't have to believe in anything as long as you got plenty of money. Now, as far as living in the subway goes, forget that. But if you want to pretend to be a prostitute, you can pretend to be one with me.
That's very sweet.
Mm-hmm. Just trying to keep my little hooker happy.
Sanford, what are you doing?
Just pretend like it doesn't mean anything anymore.
Okay. Thanks.
You're the man here now.
Right. Let's go.
Right.
Set.
Worried.
Tyler, you go first. Make sure there's no dead anything stapled to our front door.
Good idea.
Stalker stuff is kind of creepy.
You people are nuts. You're all going to get arrested.
Yeah, we don't care none. We fitting to make a stand and let women control their own bodies.
Tiffany, you won't just get a citation this time. You know, you're going to get arrested and thrown in jail with hardened lesbians.
Really?
Well, she don't care none. Come on.
I care. I do.
You have to flaunt what you have. In excess, I might add. Why don't you do it at one of the legal topless beaches?
Legal?
Well, because she ain't just about nudity. She about bringing down the system, right?
Tyler, did you know that there are legal nude beaches?
Yeah.
And you didn't tell me?
You can't protest at a legal beach. Come on, Tiff.
You idiot.
What?
You mean you were going to go around and let me get arrested when there's topless beaches I can go to?
No,
huh? I'm protesting. I'm protesting about you being my brother.
Come
now
on.
Get in there. Protest! Protest!
I was just trying to help.
Liberals.
Are you okay, Mrs. Baker?
I'm fine.
Hey, honey, how you feeling?
Okay.
Listen, I just had the weirdest thing happen at the hospital. I'm there visiting Jack Benjamin, and they bring in this car crash victim. Calm down. And all of a sudden, she grabs me by the throat like she hates me or something. Just calm
you
down.
You bastard! What? I hate you,
just
I hate you.
Just calm down.
Like
somebody put her out, please.
Touch.
Calm down, calm down, calm down. And where did these come from?
They were a gift. Go on.
Oh, anyway, she must have been delirious. So I rebuild her face. It's going to look absolutely terrific. Hey, wait a minute. While she's recovering, maybe I should ask her if she wants her breast redone.
Dr. Baker did a wonderful job on his own personal stalker. It'll be a good 2 months before she's healed enough to terrorize them again. And by then, she probably won't want to. Oh, well. It was fun while it lasted.
I saw something very funny today.
Really?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really?
What?
So?
Yeah.
Well, I stopped at the 7-Eleven to get me a beef jerky and a grape soda. Mm-hmm. Was confronted by a smelly homeless guy. As he pushed his shopping cart full of earthy belongings, dragging his lame foot wrapped in a hefty bag. Well, I noticed he was wearing a bum shirt. You know, one of those bum athletic gear shirts.
That's not funny,
you are
man.
Cold, man.
You're a pig.
Come on, Bev. Don't you want to tell him how it's the fault of the Reagan administration that this innocent man is out on the street?
Not my problem.
Come on, Miss B, why don't you tear him a new reason to riot at?
Look, am I going to have to spend the rest of my life with losers?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just thinking I had to go, and I don't remember where my birth baby pictures are, and I'm expecting a call. So, I'm going to be right back, and I want you to just keep eating and not worry about me, because I'm fine, okay? Have a good dinner.
How flipped out are these people over Mrs. Baker's apparent mental flip-flop? Well, flipped out enough to do something I've never seen them do before. Pull together and act like a family.
All I know is I want to know what the hell's going on in here.
Oh, I see.
All right. I'm weak. Sue me, Sanford. I'm a spineless jelly donut of a person.
Calm down, Mom.
Yo, everything's cool.
I need God in my life. Does that make me a terrible human being? I need enlightenment and integration and a harmonic convergence. I'm so sorry.
It's all right.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
I'm sorry.
Good to have you back.
I
like
you.
I'm
fine. I'm really sorry.
Pretty much happy.
I got cosmic track marks on my arm.
I know you
do.
I know.
I need the quest and the search. I search for the quest.
Why don't you sit down and get cosmic again? That's fine.
You know, I just need, I like to levitate. I love candles. I like incense. I like the smell of patchouli.
Julie.
I know you do, dear.
I need to...
Let's go finish dinner.
Be less than a whole person so I can
good
kind
to have
of...
you back.
Thank you. Oh, so...
Tiffany is arrested for going topless and is persuaded into protesting until she discovers that there are legal places where she can bear her assets. A deranged, anatomically correct stalker chooses Dr. Baker to vent her hostility against the anatomically incorrect Barbie look, only to discover that the Baker's house is no dream home. And Mrs. Baker's attempt at spiritual detox causes her to realize that, well, Buddha's better. People often search for enlightenment, but this week enlightenment found the Baker family of Sherman Oaks, California, and kick the crap out of them. But isn't this great crap?
Pig brother, pig sister, pig cousin, pig grandparent. All of them are pigs.
Take them down, man! Take them down, T! Take them down, man!
White people.
Take them down, T! Fuck them up, man! Fuck them up! Don't let that white boy hurt you!